I brought an actual prototype of a Starship with me, one that's similar to the photon grab that Blair's mentioning. And this isn't a design, this is an actual prototype of the Starship.
Patent pending.
Anybody who's studied radiation knows the point that alpha particles don't penetrate a sheet of paper. The idea with this particular Starship is you coat one side with an alpha-emitting particle, and the alpha particles that are emitted this way are absorbed by the paper, producing no net impulse. It pushes it a bit and it's absorbed and it stops. The alpha particles emitting this way actually produce a thrust in this direction. Now, I have nowhere near the math skills to work out what would happen with it, but apparently in about one half-life, your average alpha emitter will push this sheet of paper up to the escape velocity of the solar system. In 10 half-lives, twice that. So my thought was just a little bit of plutonium-238 on one side, put 40, 50,000 of these with a little picture of mankind like they have on the Voyager and Pioneer probes, and let them go.
I think U-232 because they have because then it's a decay chain, so that you have both half a dozen alpha particles for each.
The half life is
it's about 80 years or so.
Yeah, curium-242 gives us about a 1 year half life. Gets us a good boost. It then decays to plutonium-238, 80 afterlife, then decays to uranium-234. So you do get that multiple chain decay. But this is a message in a bottle of space, Starship. This isn't take us. You probably need some little tiny sheets of paper off the side with little steering things so that if it gets off course, you can turn it a little bit and some microelectronics. That's the design, and we're talking about on the cheap. I think the notion of putting an entire ream of paper with a manuscript, as Larry said, on it, in a half-inch carbide shield, launching it in a shot, putting it in the air, we could do that today for cheap.